Welcome back to another video. Today, I'll be going over potential reasons why you might be having a misfire code P0300. And at the end of the video, I'll be going over what caused my misfire. So this is a distributor. Basically, you have a rotor that spins in circles, and as it spins, it makes contact to all these contact points, creating spark. And the metal tabs can corrode over time, same with the rotor, and cause a random misfire. And another issue with these distributors is that it's made out of plastic, the OEM ones, and they can become old, can end up having too much play and skip timing, and ultimately that can cause your no start issue as well. Moisture can get into this distributor cap and also cause the same issue, P0300. I basically advise replacing the whole distributor cap. Pretty easy, I have a video on how to do that. And not all cars have a distributor. Some cars have a distributorless coil pack, they have a coil pack, they have coil on plug, all that fun stuff. The next issue would be a camshaft sensor. Depending on what your car is, it could be located in different locations. In the Astro van, it's located right here. It's a part of the distributor. And that camshaft sensor can ultimately go bad and misinterpret the readings and send it to the computer, allowing the computer to give false firing ratios. And you won't really get a camshaft sensor code for that. And the next issue would be crankshaft sensor, located right there on the 4.3 liters. So that crankshaft can also go bad, and it would kind of have the same symptoms as the camshaft sensor going bad, sending the false signals to the computer, all that fun stuff. Then of course we can have issues with the spark plugs. If one spark plug goes out, then you will get a misfire code for that particular cylinder. But if all the spark plugs are misgapped and not to the manufacturer specifications, then you could ultimately have a random misfire where all the cylinders are missing at random times. And to figure out the proper gapping, you need to grab your owner's manual and find the proper gapping, which is 0.06 inches for the Astro van. And you can check the gapping with this gapping tool. And that type of misfire should show under idle, and it could also only show under load, but it should pop up a code. And while it's still here, it could very well be your spark plug wire. But if that's the case, it should be popping up a engine code for that particular cylinder. Make sure all the connections are good. And if that is the case and you have that misfire, you can look up a diagram like this. And this diagram tells me that this is my sixth cylinder right here. So if I'm having an engine code for cylinder six, I can start the engine, listen to it, it's probably misfiring, pull the coil, and if it still sounds the same, then that's definitely your issue. So you can track down the coil to the spark plug. Let's say this is the wire that's bad right here. We can also see if it's arcing, and that typically happens when this wire has been scrubbing against some piece of metal, like the exhaust manifold here, and scrubbing, and the insulation is so thin that a wire is popping out and the spark is transferring from this wire to the exhaust manifold. And you could easily check that by turning off all the lights or during nighttime, crank over the car, then look at the wires and see if there's any sparks happening, because that could be your misfire. Now this issue is a bit more particular to this van, but could happen to any other car. But you can check the wiring loom, and in this van in particular, this wiring loom can disconnect from this holding place, and it can scrub onto this piece of metal here. And that goes with the entire wiring harness. Go ahead and move the harness around while it's at idle and misfiring, and see if the misfire kind of goes away as you move it around. Then you can track down if it is your wiring harness. But like I said, that spot is more particular to this van. So let's say all the sparking components are just fine. We can then check our fuel pressure. With these vans, it's common for the fuel pump to go out. This is fairly cheap, and all the tools I'll be mentioning will be linked down below for your convenience. And it'll be one great way to help out the channel. So you wanna track down the fuel rail, or the fuel line, in my case it's a fuel line, and you'll have a nipple just like this. Grab your fuel pressure tester, screw this sucker on, then simply just prime your engine. And for the Astro van, the PSI should jump up to 55 to 60 PSI. If it doesn't jump up that high at all, then either your fuel pump is bad or your fuel filter is clogged. So replace the fuel filter, recheck the fuel pressure, and if that's not the issue, you gotta replace the fuel pump. If you prime the engine and the fuel pressure is slowly going down, creeping out, and you can do it under idle, then the spider injection could very well be leaking. And that's not a fun job. It's located right in the middle of the plenum, and remove the intake manifold. So let's say all the fuel pressure looks good. We can also get some starter fluid, pop this sucker open, remove the air filter, spray some starter fluid in here, crank it over. And if it cranks over and runs for a second, then we can assume it might be dirty fuel injectors. Do you have a high mile car? or van in my case? Has it been sitting for a while? Does it sputter or perhaps have a misfire? Well, dirty fuel injectors could be your issue. If you have like an LS motor, you can easily get to the fuel injectors from the top of the motor and pull them out and clean them individually. But with the Astro van, it's not very easy to get to. So what you could do is pop open the gas tank. This is how you do it. And add some sort of fuel cleaner that is designed to clean fuel injectors. My buddy Mike, he advises using a GM fuel cleaner. I've used Tecron, and there's multiple different brands that you can use to clean your fuel injectors, but using some type of fuel injector cleaner in your gas tank should clear up some gummed up fuel injectors. And this is a good thing to check if you're getting good fuel pressure. A faulty or dirty mass airflow sensor, or MAF, could also cause a P0300. Basically, if the MAF is reading improper airflow and therefore could be dumping the incorrect ratios of fuel. So you can clean your MAF or simply replace it.
If your O2 sensors are bad, that could also send the improper signals to the computer, giving you a P0300. One of mine is located right there.
One of those red wasps just like flew into my face. I hate wasps. Anyways, sometimes it does pop up with the O2 sensor code as well, but not all the time. Why would the wasp go underneath the car and fly on my face? So we talk about the fuel pressure, but we can also check the compression. Basically, you remove all the spark plugs, you screw this hand tight into a spark plug hole, crank over the engine, and it should show you the compression each cylinder is making. Check all the cylinders. No cylinder should be more than 15% different from the highest cylinder. So if you have 150 PSI on the highest cylinder, the lowest one should not be any lower than 127 PSI. If you have low pressure in one of the cylinders, then that could very well be either faulty piston rings or, what isn't fun, a bad valve. So if the PSI is low, you can dump some oil into the spark plug hole. And if the PSI raises, then low pressure is caused by the piston rings. But if that doesn't happen, then you know that the low pressure is caused by the valves. And you'd have to get new heads, replace the valves, whatever you need to do. But let's say you have low pressure in two cylinders in the side-by-side, the head gasket could very well be blown. If your engine has had prolonged oil changes or has had a lot of dirty oil in its life, then it could very well be a stretched out timing chain. And if that's the case, you would have to replace the tensioner, its guides, and the timing chain. Finally, let's get to what caused my misfire. In the last video, I was trying to tackle my intermittent misfire. It would misfire randomly at random times. So I replaced the spark plugs, I checked the compression in each cylinder, I checked the fuel pressure, I cleaned the connections on the distributor with sandpaper, you can do the same, and I added that Tecron fuel system cleaner. And the results were that the misfire got a whole lot worse. And after hours of me trying to figure this out, come to find out, I swapped the third and fifth spark plug wires. So I had to swap them back. Now I don't have any misfire, and it idles and sounds so much better. And really simple and silly mistakes can happen to any of us. So if that happened to you, don't sweat it. So I probably missed a few issues, and if I did, comment them down below so you can potentially help other people. And I wanna say thank you to my new patron, Caleb. I really appreciate it. This is Chris of Bills United. Always appreciate any special another. I'll see you next time. The interior just does not look finished.